Chapter 10, The Definition of a Winner. Rainbow Dash was the only athlete out on the lush green Canterlot High soccer field. There was no game in progress or anything. She was just in the middle of an intense solo practice. Rainbow moved effortlessly, kicking the black and white patterned ball into the goal from across the field, one by one. Every single shot she made landed perfectly in the net. It was not that different from the way Twilight had seen Rainbow Dash, the Pegasus, knock out clouds in the sky over Ponyville. Boom, zing, pow. Already. When she kicked the last ball into the net, Applejack ran across the grass to greet her. The rest of the girls watched anxiously from the sidelines. Rainbow Dash looked annoyed at the intrusion. Rarity tried to remain positive.
They're actually talking. That's a good sign.
From afar, it appeared that Applejack was using a lot of hand gestures, and Rainbow was just standing with her arms crossed. But finally, Applejack and Rainbow Dash hugged.
Hugs! Hugs are always good!
Pinky chirped, smiling. She clapped her hands together. Applejack was shaking her head and smiling as she walked up to the group.
Somebody, and I think we can all guess who, told Rainbow Dash my bake sale had been moved to a different day. Dash showed up with a softball team and thought I was the one who canceled on her.
Just as Twilight had suspected, Sunset Shimmer was behind everything. Rainbow Dash came up to them, kicking a soccer ball and laughing.
Yeah, AJ started to give me the silent treatment, so I started giving her the silent treatment. Wasn't about to lose that battle of wills.
Rainbow pointed to Twilight.
Don't know if you've heard, but I don't lose.
Applejack rolled her eyes in a jokey way. Anyone could see that she was relieved to have her best friend Rainbow Dash back. It made Twilight feel warm and fuzzy inside to have helped.
Now, all you gotta do to get me to help you out with this whole princess vote is to beat me in a game of one-on-one.
She looked smug.
What?
Twilight's face fell, and her warm feelings turned to nerves. She'd never played soccer before. She'd read about it in the same book where she'd learned about football.
So they don't have soccer in Equestria?
Walking on two legs was hard enough. Playing a game on them was going to be no piece of apple tart. But she really needed the athletes to vote for her.
Okay.
Twilight nodded finally.
First of five goals wins.
Rainbow smiled. Then she took off down the field. The next 20 minutes were a blur. Everywhere Twilight went, Rainbow Dash was always four steps ahead of her, either blocking her way or stealing the ball. A few times, it seemed like Twilight had a clear shot, and she ended up missing the ball completely and looking really silly. But by Rainbow's fourth goal, Twilight knew she was doomed, but she didn't give up.
Go, Twilight!
Pinky squealed from the sidelines.
You can do it!
Twilight surged forward, lifting her legs behind her, and kicked hard. Then she fell flat on her backside.
Okay, maybe not,
shouted Pinky with the same enthusiasm.
But good job anyway!
A moment later, Rainbow kicked goal number 5 into the net with a satisfied grunt.
That's game!
It took Twilight a couple of minutes before she was able to catch her breath and stumble back over to the other girls. Rarity gave her a sympathetic look.
I thought you were really going to pull it out there in the end.
Yeah, right. Applejack giggled. So, what's the plan?
An excited smile spread across Rainbow's face as she jogged up to join them.
How can we make you princess over Sunset Shimmer?
But I lost,
Twilight said, confused. Rainbow Dash had said she'd help only if Twilight won the game.
Of course you lost. I'm awesome.
Rainbow smirked, hands on hips.
But I'm not going to help just anybody. The fall formal princess should be someone with heart and determination. And you, Twilight, just prove you've got them both. Yes, because princess of a high school dance is so important, and the person needs character and really good traits in life that you'll need as an adult in order to be a princess at a high school. We all know it all depends on how popular you are. The sweet shop of this realm was quite different from the one back in Ponyville. There were large, cushy couches everywhere, and the patrons sat sipping drinks and reading books. The menu offered cupcakes and slices of pie, and of course, muffins.
Muffins!
But there were all sorts of treats listed on the menu that Twilight had never seen before. Mocha chocolate bomb? Triple chocolate mint swirl cocoa? They sounded like Pinkie Pie creations. Yeah, probably. Twilight bit her lip as she stared at the big board behind the register.
Whipped caramel strawberry swirl shake?
She said to the woman behind the counter, who was busy tittering around, wiping every surface with a pink rag. She looked an awful lot like Mrs. Cake with her yellow apron and sweet expression.
And can I get that with extra oats?
Mrs. Cape put down a jug of milk on the counter and gave Twilight a sideways glance.
Oats?
In a whipped caramel strawberry swirl shake? Twilight looked over to her friends for guidance. They didn't notice because they were sprawled out on some comfy couches by the window. They all looked totally wrapped up in the chill atmosphere, just sipping their drinks and chatting. Rarity was scratching Spike's chin, absentmindedly. He looked like he was in heaven, staring up at her with puppy love eyes. Typical. Seeing them sitting there, she smiled. She could almost picture herself staying here. Are you kidding me with this sentence right here? She was getting used to how everyone looked in this realm. She didn't understand why Sunset Shimmer hadn't been able to make the best of it here. She shook her head.
However you normally make it is fine.
Twilight covered, turning back to the counter. Mrs. Cake carefully passed her the frothy drink, and Twilight kept her eyes on it as she turned around slowly to join her friends. Bam! Milkshake splattered all over the pink and yellow tiled floor as Twilight collided with somebody. But a glance up told her that it wasn't just any boy. It was
him. Oh, Flash. Oh, you man. You hunka hunka burning man.
God. This is more painful to read than watching the movie and seeing the awkward interaction between them. I mean, I don't hate Flash or anything. I think he's a really sweet, cool guy. But, you know, him and Twilight, no. No. But so this is painful as hell to read. The cute guy with the spiky blue hair stood there, god damn it, looking just as flustered as she felt. He started to throw napkins down on the mess. We have to stop bumping into each other like this, he said with a smile, stomping on the soggy napkins with his black and white sneaker. No, he wasn't, he's... Okay.
You know me, Twilight laughed nervously. I'm always trying to make a big splash around here.
As soon as the words escaped her lips, she regretted them. She sounded like such a dork. Blue-haired boy stared back and raised an eyebrow.
Because my drink kind of splashed on the ground,
Twilight ended, wincing. She should probably stop talking now. The boy chuckled at her and adjusted his black leather jacket.
Great, so now he thought she was totally awkward.
Twilight pointed to the couches stiffly.
I'm gonna go over there now.
She scampered off over to her friends and plopped down on the cushy seat. Why was it so difficult to act like a normal pony girl around him? Twilight took a sip of what was left of her sugary drink and glanced back over her shoulder. He was leaning down, cleaning up the rest of the spilled cocoa while Mrs. Cake made him another. Rarity took notice of Twilight's fascination and began to shake her head violently.
Don't even think about it. Her purple waves swished back and forth. You're already trying to get her crown. Who knows what Sunset Shimmer would do if you ended up getting her ex-boyfriend, too.
I don't even know. We just accidentally... Twilight said, desperate to deny the implications. Her face grew hot. She hadn't even realized that anyone was watching, or even who the boy even was.
Ex-boyfriend?
Fluttershy took a sip of her mint-hot chocolate.
Flash Sentry broke up with her a few weeks ago, she explained.
The girl's eyes all followed Flash Sentry as he gave Twilight a little wave on his way out of the sweet shop. No, he glanced at her like he was gonna rape face, and then left. No waving. Rarity sighed. Clearly, Twilight wasn't the only one around here who thought he was cute.
What? Now they're bringing Rarity into this? Are you kidding me with this? No. With no and so much no, I'm going to know the hell out of this no.
No.
No. Oh my god, could you even imagine Rarity having a crush on Flash? Can you imagine? They are such polar opposites, it's not even funny, you know, he's like the cool rebel and plays guitar and shit, and she's like a fashionista and Rarity. Oh, everything has to be perfect. I can't get dirty. It would just... Oh my god, I'm gonna...
Why? Why did Bear do that? Oh my god. Okay, anyway. Fluttershy shook her head.
I can't believe she hasn't done something awful to him yet.
If that were the case, Twilight couldn't help but wonder if Sunset Shimmer was waiting until she had the power to do something really awful to him. Power she would get from a certain stolen equestrian relic. Either way, Twilight thought it was best to keep her distance from Flash Sentry. At least until she got the crown back. That might be negotiable.
Oh my god. This is so ridiculous. They're making this into the world. Oh my god.
They're making Twilight, like, really, really into this crush. More than she looked in the movie. I mean, in the movie it looked like, oh yeah, she had a little bit of a crush on him, like, oh, he's cute and whatever, which is weird anyway. But with this, it's like she's really into how he looks. Like, he's, oh my god, he's super cute. And just trying to keep a distance from him, but she's like, no, I want to get close to him now. And, you know, I just want to get to know him and get, oh god. Uh-uh.